Alright guys, we've been putting together a few different videos of stuff that goes on around wide open design and everything else. And like, there's always one question that really, I think, that could use a little bit of explanation. And it's what we call flex testing stuff when we're building things. And it helps any area of a guy building a four-link project. Like, I don't care if this is on a Jeep or a buggy or whatever else. Like, this simple process, we're going to show you how we do, will ensure that you can get tire clearance, shock clearance to the frame, proper travel out of your shock, and all the other things. So, a couple of things you need to do. You need to start out with fixing the buggy on a stand. And right here we've got one of our Jeep chassis. Customer sent us his axle. We built a custom truss for it, and then we've mounted 2.5-inch King shocks on it. But we have it sitting on a belly jig to where we know where the height is. That's whatever belly clearance we want it to have at ride height. And we've got jack stands set at axle height to where the tire's going to let it ride at. So like, this is what we would call ride height. Chassis set where you want it to be, axle set where you want it to be from there. But from here, we're going to go in and check all the clearance issues that everybody always has. So I guess we'll roll the lift over here, start moving this thing around and show you what we've got. But the main important thing is, whenever you start checking this, you gotta remember one of the most important things is, make sure the axle is squared underneath the vehicle, left or right, like you want it. And then make sure that your caster's set where you want it to be on the rotation of the axle. Caster is how far back the axle's rotated, front or back. Squared up side to side, just square it up and make sure you're good to go, and make sure your wheelbase is set where you want it to be. So, Jason, let's grab this thing, plug it in, and show them around with it. Over there. First thing we're going to look at is what we call full bump. Take the axle. We've got this handy lift. You can do this, jack, the engine coils weren't really good, but we've got a lot of stuff moved out of the way to kind of help explain all this. So, right now we're at full stuff. Come over here with the camera. All right, we've got the shock compressed all the way up. On this thing, we've got right at 7 inches of up travel on it. And 7 inches of down with a 14-inch shock. But you can tell on this chassis, we've got tons of clearance. Now, if you have a stock Jeep at home or whatever else, your frame rail is going to be way down here. Everything's going to be in the way, and this is going to want to hit. And then if you've got a steering box or anything else, this being one of our Jeep chassis, it's got a lot of clearance. You don't even have to worry about anything on it. It's actually, really, you're just set free, and that's one of the cool parts about the chassis. But it's not what we're talking about today. Talking about checking all your clearances here. And if you can tell, everything we've got is tacked into place, because we want to check this before we weld anything out. We want to make sure what we got going on. So check everything out, but like full clearance, like you can just tell there's nothing hitting, but like watch all your steering ram and everything else. So what's from here, where we're going to go with this now,
all the way to full drew.
So let that side all the way down. All right, bump it up just a little bit, just to pull a little bit of pressure off up. There you go. All right, so here, you're all the way down. That's 14 inches of the shock shaft on this 14-inch shock. This right here is like what we call full drew. Again, make sure you don't have any clearance issues here. Here's where you can take, and we do it just simply with a string. This simple string, we're gonna line up where our drive shaft's gonna go and just kind of visualize from there that what kind of angles that we got. We know we're gonna have to run a carrier bearing mounted off this cross member. Man, this thing's got a high pinion axle. You're fine, like there's no angle that would be right here. So that's whenever you check all that. But like, so that one's full drew, axle all the way down on the shocks. All right, So those two right there are generally pretty easy to make clear everything happen. You want to go up this side?
Yeah.
And then let it down, all right? All right. Now, this generally where stuff gets like weird. Got this thing set where you want it. All right. So now from here is when stuff starts getting weird. All right, you got this shop 14 inches compressed all the way up. You got that shop 14 inches let all the way down. This right here is what we call full flex. And this is just talk that we use around the shop. But so you can come in here now. All that clearance we had before, we don't really have now. Come over here and look. And we'll squeeze these two fives on here. We've got right at 3/8 of an inch, 1/4 of an inch right in here with this spring slider to go on here. You know, you put a little bit bigger spring on here, you're right at clearance wise. So if you've got room, you might move that tab right here out a little bit to get yourself room. But with where we're at, it's about where it's got to be. So that's what we're going to leave it at. It's enough clearance, but it's tight. But hey, I'd rather have it tight and not rub than rub. So that's where we're at. But we do have clearance, it's just tight. But make sure you use your spring slider to check it. Don't just check the shock unless, of course, you're running air shock. So then, to check the one last clearance that really matters, that always bites you in the hind end, happens on the front end. The rear end, at this point, if you don't have rear steer, you're pretty much done. You know, you're good to go. You don't have the rear steer to worry about. Well, this thing, now you've got to take the tire and turn it to full lock. Now you can see I've got this spring slider, we got this big lug, and we clear it here, we clear it there. Now, that side over there, there's no reason to put a tire on it and worry about it. It arcs down in a way it's never gonna hit. Right here is where it's gonna hit. If you've got some kind of custom shock setup, bypasses or whatnot, you'll have to come to the front. But also check on your vehicle for frame or whatever else that the tire's not rubbing the frame. If this thing here had a lot bigger tire, we'd be in trouble. This one here's not. This is the tire we're running. I will also tell you this. Anytime you're going to this part and you're doing this kind of build, have the parts that you're going to use. Over the years, we've done builds and customer didn't want to bring us tires at the right point in time when we needed them or whatever else. And every time we try to change tires, the offset of wheel, the width of tire, that's when we always seem to really get burned. Is it never goes back like it is. But if you've got customers, not the customers, yours, when I say customers, because I'm used to working on customer stuff, but if you got the axle you're using, the shocks you're using, the steering, all the high steers already hooked up on this thing, this is the wheel and tire we're running. There's no guesswork. This thing flex tests out. Take it, tack everything up, flex it out, make sure everything works, then burn it in. But if you do this, and I don't care if it's on a Jeep or a buggy, this right here is what we call flex testing, and this right here is what you need to do to make sure you build a buggy that whenever it leaves out of the door that you know nothing's going to rub whenever you go down the trail.